Guilt is an incredibly powerful emotion that can affect many aspects of our life, starting from our thoughts, behaviors, actions, and ranging to our relationships, sense of happiness, and general sense of mental well-being. It is closely linked to remorse and shame. It encourages us to follow societal norms and live within the boundaries of our beliefs and value systems. It makes us human and makes our society cohesive. Let's start understanding this emotion that we call guilt. Guilt is a stubborn emotion and can be quite overwhelming. So on the one hand, where I talked about the positive aspects that it leads to empathy between human beings, a desire to make amends, behaviors like apologizing or changing actions in order to avoid harm in the future. Sometimes when the guilt is excessive, it can lead to negative emotions like lack of confidence, feeling of shame, anxiety, and even depression. There is a huge societal and cultural aspect to this emotion as well. In many cultures, shame and guilt are used to manage other people's behaviors and actions. Let me give you a common example. Have you heard the phrase, swear by me or swear by God? Now, asking individuals to do that means that individuals will then fear guilt and therefore not carry out that action. So understanding the biological, psychological, social, and cultural factors that cause this emotion helps us manage it better and actually use it towards personal positive growth and well-being. Today, let's start with the biological basis of why human beings experience guilt. Now, some might say that there is an evolutionary journey to the emotion of guilt because it leads to empathy between humans. It means that humans stay within the boundaries of societal rules, they respect each other and tend not to knowingly hurt each other. Now, it helps build and maintain trust. So ultimately, it is about safety and security in communities. In the brain, guilt is associated with the front part of the brain, which we call the orbitofrontal cortex. Now, this part in the front of the brain is involved in processing of rewards and punishments. It also receives and integrates information from other sensory modalities like taste, smell, somatosensory, auditory, visual, as well as other bodily sensory and motor information. Now, this part is also connected to different parts of the brain, and therefore it plays an important role in modulating motivational, emotional, and social behavior. A lot of research has been done, and it has been shown that when you do brain scans of different individuals, including those who have hurt others, like murders, the areas in the orbitofrontal cortex, as I mentioned, the front of the brain, they light up in individuals who experience guilt. Whereas in some individuals who have conducted hurtful activities, it does not light up. Now, another area of the brain called the hippocampus is involved with memories and learning from past events. The name hippocampus, interestingly, is derived from the Greek word hippocampus, which is hippos means horse and campus means sea monster, because the structure the shape of this structure resembles that of a seahorse. Now, this area stores long-term memories, the hippocampus. So when we have memories of past events that we are not proud of, we can retain a sense of guilt. We therefore try not to repeat the same things again. On the other hand, guilt can trigger changes in the levels of certain chemicals that we call neurotransmitters in the brain, like serotonin or oxytocin. And this in turn will further contribute to feelings of guilt and the desire to make amends when individuals believe that they have done wrong. So you can see where all these neural activities, they also are impacted by the neurotransmitter changes. Extreme guilt can trigger the stress response in the brain and body that leads to release of hormones like cortisol from the adrenaline glands. Now, if you haven't already, please watch my video on the biological aspects of the stress response that I have named How the Brain and Body Cope with Anxiety. Now, this stress response is a fight or flight response, which means one can either withdraw or address the situation to make amends. Have you heard of mirror neurons? The human mirror neuron system is a set of brain areas which are active both when we perform an action and when we observe another person performing the same action. Now, this area plays a role in empathy and understanding the emotions of others. Now, when we feel guilty, mirror neurons may contribute to our ability to empathize with the individuals affected by our actions. So that's how the brain learns guilt and projects the guilt. So you can see how this complex emotion has such an intricate biological basis. However, any emotion needs to be understood in the context of the interaction between the biological, psychological, and sociocultural factors. In the next video, we will discuss the psychological and sociocultural aspects of guilt. Before we discuss, what can we do about it? But today, I would like you to do this exercise. First, identify one action that makes you feel guilty. Evaluate, what is it about this action that triggers this emotion in you? Write down, what does it represent for you and the reaction of others? Watch my next video here, and if you have gained something from it, subscribe to my channel. Like it, share it, tell it to all the people you know. Thank you for watching.